So a lot of people ask us, what is multi-touch? So I want to try to explain that to you. So multi-touch is allowing more than one point of contact on a touch-sensitive surface at a given time. So older touch screens and older computers would allow for one point of contact. So I could come up to my interactive board and I can tap on it, and it's a mouse click. I could tap on the scroll bar to scroll up and down. And that was about it. Nowadays we have multi-touch, so this allows for more than one point of contact. It lets you do things like move your finger up and down to scroll up and down the screen. It lets you do things like zoom in and out. So see, I have two fingers touching the screen, I'm zooming in and out. Those are gestures. You're probably familiar with it from smartphones and tablets. That's just multi-touch. So your hardware has to be multi-touch compatible, and your software has to be multi-touch compatible. So this is Windows 8. It'll let you do gestures and multi-touch and all that fun stuff. If you have an older version of Windows or an older version of Mac, it may not do that. So even though you could buy something like this awesome Promethean touch panel, it may not be truly multi-touch if your software isn't. So one of the other things we want to show you about multi-touch is in this app here. So you can do fun things like have these great Windows apps where you can look at planets. So I can sit here in a class and I can zoom in on Venus and I can move it around. And it's really cool. So you couldn't do this back in the day, right? So now you may be asking, what about all these 4 points of touch and 6 points of touch that you see in specs everywhere? That's what we call multi-user. And that's a little bit different. A quick example of multi-user versus multi-touch is this. As we saw here, this is multi-touch. I can zoom in on Venus and move it around. Well, if I'm moving around and someone else comes over here, it's just going to zoom in further or zoom out further. It's not going to do what either of us intended, because this is just looking for those 2 points of touch to do something. So for multi-user, you not only have to have hardware that's capable of multi-user, like this Promethean screen, 6 points of touch, but you need software that's capable as well. So luckily, Promethean software is multi-user capable. So we have our flip chart up here, and we have a pen selected so we can draw. And I can write my name, and I can have Charles come up and write his name at the exact same time. So it's registering what I'm doing and what he's doing and allowing both things to happen. Versus before with Venus, it wasn't allowing both things to happen simultaneously. I want to move around, that person wants to move around, and it's just going to zoom. So this is what multi-user is. You have two students in a class writing math problems or doing something on screen at the exact same time. Different than multi-touch, but kind of the same. A perfect example of multi-user in the business world is right here. I have this blueprint on screen. Now the multi-touch is going to let me zoom in. Sorry, I forgot to turn the pen off. The multi-touch is going to allow me to zoom in and play around with the blueprint and all this fun stuff. Multi-user is going to let both Charles and I mark up these houses at the same time. So if we want to draw on here, something like that, or circle this window. As you can see, we're both doing this at the exact same time. So that's multi-user. Again, multi-touch lets me zoom out, zoom in. Multi-user lets you write. Now, yes, this did keep the annotations exactly where they were before. But the point is, we marked up the screen, now we can save it and do whatever we need to do with it. So I hope that helps. It was just a brief explanation of multi-touch versus multi-user. If you have any questions, give us a call at 866-942-6273.